Hi guys, Robert here from tmile.com, and in this video I'm gonna show you how to start selling your online courses using the free LearnPress plugin for WordPress. You can implement this feature in any WordPress website, even using the simple 2017 theme that comes pre-installed when you launch your new WordPress website. For this tutorial, I will use the free Zerif Light theme, which you can install directly from the WordPress repository. Are you ready? Let's start with the plugin installation. Head to Plugins in your dashboard and click on Add New. Search for LearnPress and install and activate the first plugin returned. There are more plugins that can extend your online school functionalities, like Course Wishlist and Course Review. I encourage you to install and activate both, because they will give a huge boost for your online business. Feel free to install any other related plugin to enable more functionalities for LearnPress. The plugin is installed now and ready to use, so what's next? Head to LearnPress Settings. First, you need to do the currency settings and tick if you wish to allow instructors registration. This option will allow you to build a team of instructors creating online courses for you. The next tab in Settings is where you choose which page will be the course page, the course category base and courses tag base. If your courses need review before publishing, tick this, and if you want to enable the editing of published courses, be sure to tick this. Further down, set the displayed courses limiting number in the archive, turn on and off the course thumbnail, and set image dimensions in single course and courses pages. For example, if your dimensions here are set to 600 pixels tall and wide, like a square image for the courses page thumbnail, here is how it looks after setup. Continue with the single course permalink structure setting and then, for the final thing, set the slug for course items like lessons and quizzes. Save the settings and move to the next tab. You have three options here: profile, quiz and become a teacher. I suggest you leave them as default, but feel free to make your own custom settings. Here is how the profile page and become a teacher page looks like as default. The only way you can receive payments with this free version of the plugin is through PayPal. Head to Add-ons and choose to pay for any extension that will integrate more payment options as needed. For now, I stick with the simple PayPal payment because it's easy to set up and requires no advanced knowledge about payment integrations. Just enter your primary PayPal email address and you're good to go. To enable testing sandbox mode, tick this box and enter your PayPal sandbox email address, then save all settings. You can use the sandbox mode to perform the payment process tests without sending any money. The place where you can set how your checkout process will work is here. For less manual work, choose to auto-enroll a user after they buy a course. Create a checkout page or simply set and edit the default one. You can view the page by clicking this link, and if you wish to get rid of the default WordPress sidebar, click to edit the page and select the full width page template, if it's available, from the drop-down list and hit Update. View the page again and you'll see it in full width without sidebar. Sure, you can leave the default sidebar on every page and use those fields to create a custom navigation menu or to promote other courses as well. The last tab is for communication settings through email, and you can personalize messages using variables below every field and by entering your own kind words. I leave content as default here for now. Now that settings are done, let's move to courses. You can set course categories and tags here, and use the Add New button to create a new course, of course. You need to set a title and a detailed description in the text editor below. This will be the title and description of your course that will be displayed on the single course page. After you finish entering all details, the next step is to enter as many sections as needed. Just set a name and hit the Enter button on your keyboard. Then, enter a name for the second section and so on until the last section of your course. Adding lessons and quizzes to the course section is easy. Keep in mind that you are able to switch every item to be a quiz or a lesson as well. Type in a title for that item, then hit the Enter button on your keyboard again. And do the same until the last one. Before I show you more about settings below, please keep in mind that you are able to drag and drop lessons and sections around, and you can edit any lesson by clicking the pencil icon right here. Further down, in the General Settings tab, choose the duration of the course, maximum students allowed, and how many students have taken this course. Set how many times the enrolled user can retake this course, and tick if you wish this course to be featured. The external link, for example, can be used to set an affiliate link for courses on Udemy. When pressing the button to buy this course, your client will be redirected to Udemy through an affiliate link and you will earn commissions for every sale. You must sign up for the Udemy affiliate program before using this feature. Furthermore, set the course results and passing condition value in the assessment tab, and you can choose some advanced options too. Set a price for your course here in the payment settings tab, and type in a lower sale price if you wish. Schedule the sale price, start date and end date here, or leave the sale price blank to remove discount. If you give this course away for free, uncheck the course payment box and hit the Save button. The last tab is where you can set the author, admin in this case, and this will be the default author for every new course. If you have multiple authors, you can select them from the drop-down list. After you finish setting all course details, add the category and related tags, then set a featured image and hit the Save Course blue button above. Next, head to Lessons in your LearnPress menu. Finally, we are ready to add content in those lessons and quizzes. Choose to enable or disable the preview here to let your future students have an idea about what's inside. Now, click to edit your first lesson. You are free to enter any kind of content you may imagine for that specific lesson, like YouTube videos, images, text, audio and more, using plugins that will allow you to create custom content in the text editor. Before publishing a lesson, remember to set the duration, then tick if you wish to allow the preview. Again, you can enable or disable that later on using the switch in the lessons list. Now, let's see how you can add quizzes to the end of each section or to the end of the course. This is a good way to let students know if they have reached a new level of knowledge after finishing a section. Head to Quizzes in LearnPress, then add a new quiz or edit the existing ones. Enter a description in the text editor below the title, then move further down and start adding questions. After you type in the question, press Enter and select Answers from the drop-down. You can choose True or False, Single Choice or Multi-Choice. Let's choose the Single Choice for this one, then edit the answer with multiple colors like yellow, green and blue. Tick which answer is correct, then hit Update. The final quiz is ready and you will see it in action later on as a student. The course is done, lessons are filled with content and quizzes are set, so let's take a preview of this demo course. Looks great, isn't it? If you wish to make it look different, I suggest you check out our free and premium themes in the description box below and choose your preferred one. Now, you can start selling your first online course. Before moving on, I suggest you be sure that anyone can register as participant function is enabled in your general settings of your dashboard. Let's see it in action and how it works as a student. Head to the course page and hit the Enroll button below the description. Create a new account and check your email for your username and use the link in that email to set a password. Now you are able to log in and enroll in that course for free. Start with the first lesson and click Complete whenever you feel you are ready. Then move to the next lesson. You will see the progress of your learning level in the left upper corner of the screen, represented in percent of the complete course. The last lesson in this section is actually a quiz, so let's see how it works. Click Start Quiz and once the loading of questions is finished, tick the answer you may consider correct. Then click Next or Finish Quiz. Click OK in the pop-up message, then you will be able to see detailed information about your results. Once the course is completed, I encourage you to let students know that they can write a review and look for other courses to be saved to their wishlist for further learning. I hope that this tutorial was helpful enough and I covered every detail about the LearnPress WordPress plugin. If not, please let me know your questions in comments below this video. I would be happy to answer them all. Thanks for watching. Click the parrot on the screen right now to subscribe. Then click the bell and check send all notifications for this channel. This way, you'll be notified every time we upload our latest tutorials about WordPress. Share them if you like what you see. Hit the like button and ask any question in comments below.